It's widely considered as one of the greatest ultramarathon world records of all time. 303 kilometers in 24 hours. Now, you could make a case for other performances, but the more you look into this one incredible record, the more you realize how stunning this performance was. This seemingly unbreakable record was set back on October 4th of 1997 by the one and only Yiannis Kouros. For this one-day world record run, Kouros averaged 4 minutes and 44 seconds per kilometer, or 7 minutes and 38 seconds per mile. Yeah, that's pretty absurd to run this pace for an entire day. For many people, achieving just 1 mile at this pace would be quite the achievement, but running at this tempo for 24 straight hours is almost inconceivable, even for many of the greatest ultramarathon runners to ever live. Legend has it that Kouros actually had an out-of-body experience for this run, as he saw himself running from above the track for this race. For well over 20 years now, this distance has stood unrelenting against any other competition. In fact, the closest that anyone has ever been to this record was 282 kilometers back on September 3rd of 2006. Indeed, holding a record by such a massive margin for over two decades is already impressive, but what is even more remarkable is that Yiannis actually managed to run farther than his next closest competitor on 11 separate occasions. This absolute stranglehold on the 24-hour run is just one of the events where Kouros has reigned supreme over the years. But now, there's another challenger emerging, and he's also considered as one of the greatest ultramarathon runners of all time. Hailing from Catalonia, Spain, Kilian Jornet will soon be attempting to break the 24-hour run world record. Over the years, Jornet has been almost unbeatable when it comes to mountain running, but it's not just in high elevations where this Spaniard finds success, as he also has solid natural speed in shorter distances. Recently, he competed in a 10K road race in Norway, where he ran a time of 29 minutes and 59 seconds, which, considering that he rarely runs any distance shorter than a marathon, this is quite the impressive performance. Given his previous decade of solid mountain accomplishments, Jornet is clearly very comfortable in hilly terrain. But given that his next race will be 24 hours on a completely flat surface, this just might be his most difficult challenge to date. What made Kouros such a remarkable ultramarathon athlete was his almost transcendent ability to tone out the pain. He even stated that when other people get tired, they stop. I don't. I take over my body with my mind. I tell it that it's not tired, and it listens. This mind-over-body mentality was a huge asset for Kouros over the years, and it certainly helped him run 758 times around a 400-meter track back in 1997. But the question now is, can Kilian Jornet match this record? And if so, how far will he run? The primary challenges for such a race are very different than your typical weekend road running event. First and foremost is the ability to properly manage your calorie intake without your body betraying you into digestive disaster. Even if you only need just one additional bathroom break over this 24-hour period, this kind of stopping will not only waste additional time, but it will break your body's natural running rhythm, making it much more difficult to settle back into your pace. Next is the ability to properly care for your legs and your feet. Through much of ultramarathon running, blistering, cramping, and excessive chafing altogether can completely ruin the ability to complete a task. For this particular race, Jornet will be faced with the monumental challenge of running exclusively on a track, which will ultimately result in focused pressure points on his muscle groups and his feet where he lands. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, is the mental aspect of ultramarathon running. As we previously mentioned, Kouros had a world-class mental approach to his running, and while Jornet certainly has a strong mind, it will be very interesting to see how he handles running exclusively on a track. Unlike mountains, which offer a plethora of inclines, terrains, and also beautiful views, running on a track will get very monotonous very quickly. Even Jornet himself admitted that this track-only race will definitely be monotonous. However, the world record attempt is simply too enticing. Now, I've asked a lot of people about this world record attempt, and almost all of them have said that Kilian Jornet will not break this record. Again, Kouros' record is over 20 kilometers ahead of the next closest athlete. However, if there is one runner right now that has any chance whatsoever, Kilian Jornet just might be that person. In order to achieve this record, he will need to cover each lap of the track in 1 minute and 54 seconds. And while many can achieve this pace for quite a while, running for 24 hours straight at this pace will be one of the greatest challenges he has ever faced. Now I'll pass the question off to you guys. How far do you think Jornet will run over this 24-hour period? And does he have a shot at Yiannis Kouros' world record? Leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, everyone. And as always, until next time.